Hello everyone, let's solve this problem. Here is a number line. Tick which of these inequalities is shown on the number line. So this is the number line and here are the four options. Before we begin, I'm going to ask you to see a video I made on basic inequalities, inequality symbols and rules. So there you can see the notations, the greater than, the less, the greater or equal to, and the less than or equal to. So, for example, for the greater than or equal to, the circle is shaded and the arrow points to the right. For less than or equal to, the circle is going to be shaded and the arrow is going to point left. For greater than, it's going to be an unshaded circle and the arrow is going to point right. For less than, an unshaded circle and the arrow is going to point left. So if we apply these principles, we would see that here on negative 2, we've got an unshaded circle. So this means that this inequality sign here is either a less or a greater than. So what it means is that the inequality symbol does not have an equal sign, but the arrow tells whether it's less or greater. So because this line extends from left to right, so it's obvious that this is a greater than. So this symbol here is a greater than. So let's move to point 5. So we see that the circle on 5 is shaded. So this tells us that the inequality symbol here has an equality sign. So it's either a less than or equal to or a greater than or equal to. So, but how do we know? We can see that from this point, the line points to the left. So this tells us that it's a less than or equal to. And because it points left, so it's a less than. So because it's shaded, I'm going to add. So this is a less than or equal to. Here, we've got a greater than. So this point right here is n greater than negative 2, and this point here is n less or equal to 5. So what we have to do now is to combine these inequalities, these two inequalities, n greater than negative 2 and n less than 5. So this is the analogy I'm going to use. We all know that 2 is less than 3. So if 2 is less than 3 and I want to have 3 before 2, then the sign is going to be reversed. 3 is greater than 2. By virtue of that, if n is greater than negative 2, what it implies is that negative 2 is going to be less than n. So this is how I'm going to combine both inequalities. So I'm going to have negative 2 less than n, and of course, n is less or equal to 5. This is the representation on the number line. Negative 2 less than n less than or equal to 5. So the next thing is to figure out which of amongst the options tallies with the solution. So of course it's not option A. Okay, the second option, yeah, perfect. So I'm going to tick. This is our answer. Negative 2 less than n less than or equal to 5. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, kindly like, subscribe, and share it. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.